Today is a special day. Today we have with us a young and upcoming all-rounder from Mumbai. He's just not knocking on the doors of the selectors. He's trying to demolish it altogether. In very short time, he has become the backbone of Mumbai cricket team. Mumbai's player for all season and for all situations, Shams Mulani. Welcome, sir. We are great to have you. We are grateful to have you on the show.
Thank you so much.
It's been a real pleasure talking to you, and we are looking forward to it. So, Amok, can you take the first question?
Yes, sure. So, the first question is that when we think of Mumbai cricket, basically, Shivaji Park is the first thing that comes to our mind. You must be having surely some fond memories of Shivaji Park right from when you started playing cricket. So, would you please describe how you started playing, and then when did the feeling sink in that I want to make my career in cricket?
First I was at Matunga Gymkhana when I was like 5 years old. So after that, I trained over there. Then when I was 9, there was this big selection at Shivaji Park Gymkhana. Praveen Amre sir, Sandesh Kaule sir, and Paddy Shivalkar sir were the coaches over there. And obviously, they are a very big name in Mumbai cricket. So everyone wanted to, go under their coaching and get into that academy. And Shivaji Park has his own history, which is very massive. So everyone wanted that, and me as a budding cricketer also wanted to get into the best coaching facility there was. So there was this big selection, around 1,000 guys came. It was around for 3 or 4 days, when I was 9 years of age. And luckily, I got selected for my batting mostly. And Praveen Amre sir was just behind watching me, and I played some few shots, and he was very happy with that. And that's how I got selected in the Shivaji Park Gymkhana circuit. And then, playing under big names, Shreyas Iyer was there at that time, Tushar Deshpande was there at that time. And these guys who were very important in the Mumbai circuit were also there. And watching Harmeet Singh, Siddhesh Lad, Shardul Thakur, it gave me a push, I have to play like them, I have to be like them, I have to grow like them. And that's how my cricketing journey started.
That's great to hear, sir. So the next question that we would be asking, as you mentioned, Praveen Amre sir, I think he is there in the DC camp also, and recently he was selected as a replacement for Akshar Patel for Delhi Capitals. So how was it reconnecting with Praveen Amre sir?
I think he's been my coach since I was 9, and he's always there for me, for my batting, bowling, all-round performances. He's always there for me. I still go to his academy to practice, Amre's Cricket Clinic. And the first thing, when I got a call from the DC management, and I didn't know what to say, I didn't know what was happening, because it was all of a sudden, and I was the first ever replacement, COVID replacement. So I didn't know what it was. And the next call I got was from Praveen Amre sir, because he was very happy that his student is, getting into DC, where he's an assistant coach. So it was great for him. So he called me up, he congratulated me. And when I went over there, he's just asking me, how's everyone treating you? How are the players? And we discussed a few things. And Ajinkya Rahane was also there. So it was a great feeling to, play under them, be under them.
One more interesting thing. As you said, Shreyas Iyer is in DC camp. Prithvi Shaw is in DC camp. Tushar was in DC camp. Even Ajinkya Rahane. So are we forming a little Mumbai in DC camp?
I don't know about that. Maybe.
So maybe if DC and MI are in final together, Mumbai fans won't feel bad. Either way.
Yeah, they won't.
That has happened once actually in 2020.
Yes.
The third question is that when you were in Mumbai Indians as a net bowler for the season 2020, that was your first step in the IPL. And then now you are a replacement of Akshar Patel in DC. So how was it, just describe how was the experience with Sachin Tendulkar, then Ricky Ponting, and all these great legends?
When I got into the Mumbai Indians camp, obviously, it was in Abu Dhabi and Sachin sir wasn't there with us. But I was under, Mahila Jayawardhane sir and Rahul Sanghi sir and Zaheer Khan sir. And they were constantly, just watching me, giving me some tips here and there, and watching the legends who are playing right now in the team, and Rohit Sharma, Karan Pollard, etc., etc., Hardik Pandya, Kunal Pandya. It was, you know, an amazing feeling that you are aspiring to be one of them. You are aspiring to play for a IPL franchise and get a big, you know, name out of it, and just you want to play over there, that platform, which is a very big thing for me. So just I grasped everything in how they train, how they practice, what professionalism goes through, you know, to be at the highest level, which I saw. And in DC, when I just went for practice, I first met Ricky Ponting, sir, who's just, you know, an amazing guy. He's a legend of the game, but you know, he never makes you feel that you are just a budding cricketer. He's like a friend. He's like a brother. Whenever, whatever you need, you can just go and ask him. So I remember that once I was bowling, and I think I had finished my bowling spell, and but the batsman was still going on. So I asked him that I'm done, and he didn't even hesitate. And he's like, okay, cool. Then he just replaced me. So it's like, it was very professional. He knew how to manage the players, how to manage the bowlers, and everything made me feel like, you know, I'm the part of this team from the start, and I didn't came in between. So I think what I learned most was professionalism and how they prepare themselves for the game, which was very important, what I feel. And so yeah, that was an amazing experience.
You know, one question I would like to ask you. We have seen Rohit Sharma grooming young players a lot. So how much of an influence he was in MI camp?
I think he was a very big influence, because, you know, he practiced as if he's playing a match, and he didn't, you know, give you anything. If you bowl a bad ball, if you do anything, he's going to hit you for a six, which was very evident over there. And he was very professional about it. And even after his batting, he used to come and, you know, talk to us. If suppose we have any questions, he would stand with us. He would talk to us. If I'm asking something to him that, sir, agar mujhe ye karna hai, toh what do I need to do? He would give his, you know, peace of mind, what he thinks about us and what we do. So it was, you know, like a guy who's a legend, who's grooming, is trying to help us youngsters going forward, which is a great feeling.
Definitely. I mean, he definitely seems like a laid-back character. He takes things really easily.
Yes,
that's a sign of a great leader.
Yeah, definitely.
Going forward, sir, as we were going through your Instagram profile, you know, we saw a video wherein you were practicing fielding, but there was something unusual. It was not a usual session. There was a mat which we used to cover the pitch, and there was water on top of that, and then you guys were just diving on that. So can you just describe how that experience is? I mean, what do you basically do when you try and field that way?
Yeah. So that was in NCA, basically National Cricket Academy at Bangalore. So we had a fielding session where we were practicing sliding and diving. As obviously, if suppose you don't know how to slide, you can't go and slide on the ground because it will hurt you. So there's this training session where you put mat, then you put soap water in it so that you can slide easily. And actually, we had finished all the fielding drills and everything, and we were just having fun that time, just sliding and thinking, like watching who was sliding the most or who was sliding like perfectly. So that was going on. There was just a fun day that day.
Certainly.
That's interesting.
You know, you have played the Emerging Players Cup for Under-23 for India. Yeah. And we can't say that tournament was bad for you, but it was not a breakthrough year for you either. But then, after reading one article that we come across, I think Narendra Hirwani was your bowling coach for that season. And then onwards, your life changed. You were tagged as a specialist bowler for limited overs, even in death. So, how was that experience? How was interacting with Hirwani, sir?
Yeah, I had gone to NCA before, and I had met Hirwani, sir. But it was for a very few days, a couple of weeks, that is. And I think he helped me a lot. He understood what my bowling was. And, you know, he helped me. He didn't, he liked my action, so he didn't change much. He just told me a few tricks wherein it could help me as a bowler when things aren't going my way. So that's what he shared with me in the India Under-23 camp as well, wherein he told me that it's all in the mind. You don't have to think too much. because somewhere I was stuck between, you know, the red ball bowler and a white ball bowler, which I had in mind. And so he just told me that it's just in the mind. You are just a bowler, and you, if you get the ball, red, white, whatever, you have to deliver on that day. So it's in your mind. If you keep your mind strong, if you keep your body strong, then I think you don't have to worry about anything. And that's how, you know, he helped me mentally. And he talked a few things in between in my run-up and everything, which helped me a lot and gave me a lot of composure.
Talking about Irwani, sir, is there any difference do you see in the mindset of spinners of old school days and today's spinners? Because if you see spinners today, like Rashid Khan, he likes to bowl very fast. He does not give any flight. But if you see bowlers from yesteryears, there were a lot of their reliance for wicket taking was tossing the bowlers. So is there any change in mindset, or how does it go?
I think as generation changes, the game changes. I'm not saying that the game wasn't as good as it is right now. It was over there as well. But the thing was, the type of cricket changes, I feel. Since T20 has come, people have started, you know, looking at strike rates, hitting power. So the bowler also has to change something, and the ground is not as big. So, and white ball is like, even if you miss it and if you have the power, it's going to go for a six. So you have to be pretty smart about it and how you want to bowl. Yes, flight is always there. Flight cannot go out of the out of cricket anytime. I feel, because in T20s as well, if there's help for the spinners, definitely I've seen some flighting the ball and getting wickets. And I think that's what it is, you know, change in generation, change in the cricketing, this thing. T20 formats and 50 over formats have changed a bit. And batsmen have, you know, started playing different shots as well. Reverse sweep, you see, every other batsman plays the reverse sweep, and it's quite difficult for a bowler. So they have to, you know, keep changing, keep working their bowling actions as well.
So moving forward, tell us about your plans as we see so many left-hand all-rounders coming ahead in Akshar Patel or in Krunal Pandya.
I think, I've been an all-rounder for all my life, I feel. So my plan is just, you know, that I can compete with them at that level, you know, trying to get into the Indian team, where every child's dream is to play for India. Every cricketer's dream is to play for India. So I don't think that I'll talk that any much. I'll be an all-rounder, and my plans are just, you know, try and improve my fitness, my game, my skills, and compete with them, with the legends, with the big names on that platform. I think that will be great for me.
Just a random question. We haven't seen left-arm spinners bowling dusra. Like off spinners, the right-arm off spinners, they usually have more variation. But left-arm off spinners generally tend to bowl only the orthodox style and arm ball. So, are you developing any new variations? I mean, just
yes, you know, you have to develop new variations, you know, because as I said earlier, the game is moving pretty fast. So yes, there is a thing going on, you know, wherein a variation is much needed in these days. And I'm working on that as well, which we might be able to see soon in the coming up matches. So, yeah, it is there. You have to change with the game. Righties, I feel, you know, in India, off-spinners, barring a couple of them, like Ashwin and Harbhajan Singh, sir, like, barring a couple of them, Indians don't try to, like, dominate off-spinners. That's what I feel. They try to dominate. And that's why, you know, off-spinners, the most punishment, and if you get punishment, you learn, and that's how, you know, that's how you develop dusras or the carom ball or everything, which is quite necessary, and that's what I feel. So I think I'm also working on that, because in the coming days, it's necessary that, you know, you have variations, especially in T20 cricket. So I'm also working on that.
That's nice to know, sir. Hope we see a lot of wickets in the upcoming matches. The next question is about the 2018-19 Vijay Hazare Trophy run of Mumbai. It was a pretty special season, because Mumbai, I think, won 9 consecutive games in that tournament. So can you just take us through those feelings in the tournament? Because winning that many games continuously is a very big achievement. So what was the atmosphere like in the dressing room when you started the tournament and when you ended it, the process basically? Can you just take us through that?
Yeah, definitely. So I think when we started the tournament, we didn't, you know, think of being the best, or just we thought we'll take one game at a time and, you know, perform at our best, this thing. So that's how we progressed. That's how we, you know, started playing, and we had a great team, to be honest. I think it was one of the best team Mumbai has seen in like last 5 years, 6 years. So, and everyone knew their job pretty well, and everyone clicked at the right time. It wasn't like if suppose Prithvi is playing or Iyer is playing, they are only scoring the bulk of the runs. When the time came, there were Aditya Tare, there was Siddesh Lad, lower down the order, who was scoring runs for us as well. So I think it was a pretty, it was like a dream season for Mumbai cricket, as we won every game convincingly, and didn't have to, you know, think about anything else. Just try to do your job. Suppose I'm a left-arm spinner, I'll do my job. Tushar Deshpande is a fast bowler, he'll do his job, that's it. We didn't have to, you know, think about anything else. And so it was, and we progressed each game. We took each game at a time, and, you know, we won it convincingly.
Sir, just an add-on question to that. Yeah. Is there a pressure playing for the Mumbai cricket team? Because it's always a very hyped team that it has won 41 or 42 Ranji titles, and wo hype hamesha rehta hai ki yaar, the expectation levels are very high. So, yeah. Bahar se pressure kitna hota hai ki when you're playing for Mumbai?
I think pressure is always there. Pressure is going to be there if you play for Mumbai, because it has a very big heritage behind it. And it's always there, you know, because Mumbai cars, they don't like losing at all. And even if you lose a match, we all feel pretty sad about it. So I think playing for Mumbai, there is a pressure. There is a constant thing in the mind that you're representing Mumbai. So even if there's a loss, everyone loses. It's not like the team loses. It's like it's like Mumbai loses, because it has so many players who are watching us, who are following us whenever we play. So, and in any age group, it's not like only in Ranji Trophy. I think in every age group, everyone, you know, looks, where is Mumbai? Is Mumbai playing the knockouts? Is Mumbai winning? So everyone has their eye on Mumbai. So I think the pressure is from under 14 level itself, that you're playing for Mumbai, you're representing Mumbai, you have to win. Like, it's there. You can't win every game, but the pressure is like, you have to win every game, because Mumbai has its own very big past and glory. So yeah, after glory comes pressure of continuing that glory.
Also, Mumbai has given a lot of stalwarts to Indian cricket, basically. So that can be another reason. Yes.
Okay. Yes.
My next question would be, as you said, Mumbai has a tendency to produce heroes per match. Like every other match, some other players puts up his hand and does whatever the team needs. Like Mumbai has a tendency to make stars out of players. So talking about one thing, on 9 December 2019, Mumbai had a game against Baroda. And talking about one player coming up, you had a fantastic run. You were the top scorer on the first innings. You took 6 wickets and ended up taking your first 10 wicket haul. So, walk us through that match. How was it?
Yeah, so to be very honest with you, I wasn't feeling that well about my bowling going in that match, because I was just, you know, trying to find out the right pace I need to bowl on that wicket and everything. So, we were batting first, and I think before lunch only, me and my fielding coach, Unkar Murao, so I just went to him. I was like, there were nets behind them on the ground. I was like, we need to go there and we need to work on my bowling, because I don't think I'm right there right now. Because Ranji Trophy is a different ball game than Syed Mushtaq Ali or Vijay Hazare. And there are quality batsmen with patience, and you need to, you know, keep bowling in the right areas to get a wicket. So we went over there and we were bowling for a couple of hours till the lunch break. We were just trying to find the right pace which I needed to bowl on the wicket. And after that, when I thought that I found the right pace, in the first innings, and when I was bowling, it helped me a lot, you know, the way I was practicing. I was just reflecting that on the ground and it was helping me a lot. And that's how, you know, things went through. That's how I gained my confidence, you know. When you take the first couple of wickets, you have a good confidence in you that you, I think you can do it. You think you can do it. And everyone, you know, is backing you up. So I think it was a very good day for me that I got 6 wickets and in the match, I got a 10-wicket haul.
We all hope it's just a start. It's just a tip of the iceberg.
Yes,
it is. Moving ahead. So I would like to ask you how easy or how difficult it was in a bubble life, and how different was it in Dubai and how different was it in India? Like, what was the difference between the two and how easy or difficult it was?
See, bubble life is, I don't think it's easy. It's never been easy for me because staying in a room, getting quarantined in a room is pretty tough on the mind as well. If you don't play, if a cricketer, his job is playing, and if you don't play, you have this tendency, you get anxious sometimes, you have this, you know, okay, I want to go out and play, I have to get out of this room. And I think mentally it disturbs you a bit, but you have to be strong because at the level you're playing, you have to, you know, go there, perform each time whenever you get an opportunity. So I just, you know, keep thinking about that whenever I get a chance, you know, keep thinking about the game, the opponents we are gonna face, which helps me a lot to pass my time in quarantine period or in a bubble period, wherein if you win the matches, you don't feel that much, you know, everything's going good, everything's happening and everyone's happy. But if you lose a match, if you lose a couple of matches in a row, that's the time wherein, you know, the anxiousness of what is going to happen, that what you don't know what is going to happen in the future. Your confidence is a bit low. So I think that time the bubble situation isn't good for the light-minded people. That's what I feel. So yeah, it is difficult. Abu Dhabi, when we were in Abu Dhabi, obviously Abu Dhabi is a very, very, very strict city. Or a state. So yeah, we had certain rules we needed to follow, and if we didn't, we had a very big fine on our hands. So, you know, everyone had to keep in the bubble, and you cannot break the bubble as such. In India, what I feel is that Indians, you know, it was a very, very good bubble as well, but it didn't have any space for us in the domestic circuit, you know, where we can go and have our thing in a bubble. There weren't any spaces. That's what I felt, that we needed some spaces like we had in Dubai, to roam around, to feel that, you know, you are outside, but actually in a bubble. So that was my experience. That's it.
Sir, also, I wanted to ask you one question, which I felt is important here. Is that how do neutral venues matter? Does it change your game, or does it change your mindset, or how does it matter to you?
I think neutral venues, you know, it gives, like, if suppose there's a neutral one venue, you have to read the conditions pretty quickly. So you grow as a cricketer. That's what I feel, you know, playing in different conditions. Obviously, the home advantage, everyone wants a home advantage, wherein you know what you can do on the wicket. You've practiced over there, you've played over there. But I think neutral venues, you have to adapt very quickly. And the ones who adapt are going to progress. And that's what happens in the international level as well, wherein in a test match, each day, the wicket changes. And suppose in ODI cricket or T20 cricket, you have to play in different conditions, when sometimes it may seam or it may spin. So I think as a batsman, as a bowler, the ones who adapt to different conditions are the ones who are going to succeed. So I feel that it's better as a cricketer to grow playing in neutral venues. You'll grow as a cricketer. That's what I feel.
You know, just one thing to add. After the IPL got cancelled or IPL got rescheduled, even the first game that got postponed between RCB and Sunrisers, I think.
KKR.
RCB and KKR, the first game that got postponed. As a fan, it was really devastating. But as a player, it must have been much worse for you. So can you just walk through how was the atmosphere in dressing room? Was there any anxiety?
I think, you know, no one thought that IPL is going to get cancelled and or postponed. So everyone, you know, everyone was very this thing about it that yes, the only one match was postponed and we're gonna play the next games and everything. And it happened very quickly since in our this thing also there was one guy was positive. So it happened very quickly. We got quarantined very quickly. And you know, every precautions were done, but mentally, yeah, there is this feeling, you know, IPL is there, you get an opportunity to learn from the players, even if you're not playing, even if you're part of the team, you get an opportunity to learn, which was taken away, sadly, due to this pandemic. And so, yes, it was a shock at first that, you know, it took a bit of time to, you know, just grasp everything what was going on. But end of the day, you have to do what you've been told. And it was necessary that it had to be postponed. So, yeah, you just have to accept the fate and nothing else.
That's right, sir. It was shocking for each one of us that the IPL was not going to be there every evening. But going ahead, sir, we would really like to know your ability to bowl in the death overs, because for a spinner, bowling in the death overs and, you know, your economy is less than 7 bowling in the death, which is amazing, which is an amazing achievement for a spinner to bowl in death overs, because we see what happens in the death overs, right? So how did you develop the skill of bowling in the death overs with so much of confidence and maintaining an economy which is below 7 for a spinner?
To be honest, you know, in Mumbai cricket, if you're playing, the level of Mumbai cricket is so high that even if you're playing a domestic game or a club game, you have to be on your mark, or otherwise, you know, you get hit by the batsman. And that's how everything is progressed. You know, once you get hit, once you get, you know, punished in a game, you obviously understand how you need to bowl. So the experiences of me getting punished in the games, in the club games, and, you know, an MPL or whatever you say, whatever games I play, if suppose I've got punished, you need to learn from them. And that's how I've developed it. You need to learn from the games you've done badly, so that when suppose you find yourself in that situation, you will obviously use that experience to your best effect and try to contain the batsman. So that's what I feel. You know, if you get punishment, you learn. As I've also got a lot of punishment in the Mumbai club games as well. So that's how I learn. That's how we all learn. And I think that helped me. And, you know, you just have to learn from your mistakes, and that's going to help you, and that experience is going to help you in the times to come ahead.
Surely, sir. We really hope that we get to see the same skill when you play for the Indian team. So, yeah, we would really like to see that. Kaustu?
Yeah. Moving ahead, this year, Syed Mushtaq Ali Trophy, the Mumbai squad was supposed to be the favorite one. Like, this was the year that Mumbai finally grabs the Syed Mushtaq Ali Trophy. You had the star-studded pack like Aditya Tare, Surya Kumar Yadav, Shreyas Iyer. But sadly, the Syed Mushtaq Ali, Mumbai was, I mean, the performance was really not up to the mark. But then something, you know, phenomenal happened, and Vijayadare Trophy, you people looked like a completely different team. Like, there was no one else to beat you around. It did not like Mumbai will lose. So what was different between the two tournaments? How did you prepare yourself mentally? For skill does not go away. Team was the same. So what was the difference between the two teams?
You know, I've discussed it with a couple of ex-Mumbai cricketers as well, from Mumbai cricketers. So they've just said that to me, that the preparations were lacking because it was COVID, and then suddenly there was Syed Mushtaq Ali, and Mumbai obviously being hit very badly with this pandemic. We didn't have any opportunities to go and practice because we were all staying home. I think preparations obviously were different in both the scenarios, because in Vijay Hazare, we had a lot of time to prepare. We had, you know, our own personal practices because the lockdown was lifted. But going into Syed Mushtaq Ali, we didn't have that much time to gel as a team, or, you know, to obviously there is a this thing, gelling is very important in a team. even if you have best players who've been playing with each other for a very long time, but if they don't play regularly, the team won't gel. As we had a lot of youngsters as well this season, in this year, Syed Mushtaq Ali. I thought that preparations were, we lacked in preparations. And as I said earlier in the bubble life, if you lose a game, you start doubting yourself, and then you know, all the pressure comes back to you and everything happens. So I think it was just an off tournament for the Mumbai guys, because I thought we were doing pretty well. We were doing well, but we couldn't, you know, close the games which we needed to. And that's what reflected on our performances as well. You know, you lose a couple of games and then you lack a bit of confidence going into the third game. That's what happened, I feel. And it happens to the best of the best. It's not like, you know, it's just happened to a few teams. It happens to the best of the best. And I think bouncing back in the Vijay Hazare was something which was very important to us, as our coach also, Ramesh Pawar sir, he also discussed with us, you know, how we need to bounce back, what we need to do, how disciplined we need to be in this bubble life, that, you know, we don't need conflicts in the team, because that's what happens when you're in a bubble. You start blaming each other and things go south. So I think that's what helped us, you know, the first speech that Ramesh Pawar sir gave, and which showed us that he's here to help the team win. And that's what he did. And when we were playing, since we were winning, the team atmosphere was at a very high level, and which helps a lot. You know, once you start winning, you want to keep that momentum going and you want to keep dominating, as we had this motto that we are here to participate. We aren't here to participate. We are here to dominate. So that's what we had in mind as well. You know, that Mumbai cricket is known for its dominance, and I think we need to show that we are dominant. It was just a tournament which went bad for us. I think we needed to bounce back, and we did pretty well.
Certainly, the thing you said, like, we are here to dominate. I think that is the characteristic that Mumbai cricketers have. They don't. Yeah. They value their wicket too much. They don't give away.
Yeah. Yes, definitely.
So just a quick question, if I may ask. The whole Vijay Hazare Trophy tournament that just concluded, just a quick word on Prithvi Shaw, because the double centuries, the centuries were just not stopping. So, you know, just a quick word on him. How did you feel sitting outside and watching those innings very closely?
Yeah, see, he is like a fantastic batsman, as we all know. And when he gets going, you just can't stop him. You can bring on the best bowlers in the world, but still you can't stop him. And that's how he started the tournament. You know, he started the tournament with a century against Delhi, and it was a very dominant performance. And you could see in his eyes that, you know, he was very hungry for those runs, and he wanted to be there till the end and you know, help the team win, which was very important. As an opener, you want to be there. You want to have, you know, this thing that you want to be there in the end and win games for Mumbai. And that's what he did. And he started off brilliantly. And then moving forward in the game, in the tournament, he just kept that momentum going. And since we had lost to Pondicherry in the Syed Mushtaq Ali, I think he had his revenge. In that game, when he scored a double 100, it was just spectacular watching him play those shots and, you know, just expressing what talent he has. I think he did that in the whole tournament and made everyone everyone proud.
Yes, sir. It was great to see Mumbai back.
Sir, a quick question from my side related to this same topic. So my question is that during the Vijay Hazare Trophy, Suryakumar was the captain for Mumbai. But then when he got his India call-up, then the captain changed and Prithvi became the captain. So how was it, you know, how was it different from Sky's captaincy and Prithvi's captaincy? Was it anything? Because Prithvi was, he's a young captain and he's playing under all experienced players. So how was it under Prithvi Shaw?
I think Shreyas Iyer was the captain and then Prithvi became the captain. Yeah. So, obviously, there's there's a bit of difference in everyone's captaincy. Someone is a bit aggressive, someone likes to take safe mode. But I think Prithvi, he understood the players he was playing with. And since we've been playing for a very long time now, he knew what each other's game was, and you know he had this belief in each and every one as a cricketer, as an individual, that if he's gonna perform, he's gonna do his best for the team, and he's gonna be a match winner. So that's what it was, him believing in us. As Shreyas also, he was also a fantastic captain. He knew how to shuffle the bowlers. He used his experience of captaining the Delhi Capitals side for the last couple of years, and India A sides as well. So he used his experience, wherein he shuffled the bowlers pretty well. And Prithvi, he just believed in each other's performances, talents, and then he just used to give us the upper hand and let us do the talking with the ball or the bat. So yeah, that was it.
Sir, one more thing that I would like to ask is, how much of an injury concern that an all-rounder has? Because you have to do the double labor, because you have to bowl in the nets, but then you have to go back and bat also. So how much the diet helps? And also one more thing is that how much of a physio plays work, like the recovery that you do in the post-match, like the massages and everything that they do. So how much of an impact does that have in recovery?
I think they are the unsung heroes, the masseur, the physio, and everyone, the trainer. They are the unsung heroes of any cricket team, what I feel is that, because they work tirelessly on the rest days we have, and help us if we have any niggles or if we have any body part which we need to be massaged. They are always there. They'll never say no to you, even if you call them at 12 o'clock with any problem in the at night. That's what I feel. Their contributions are very, very important, which normal people, they don't see it. They just see the players who are performing. But I think the thing that work goes on is that's very important as an all-rounder to be around them. If you have any niggles, because you get niggles as you do the both departments of batting and bowling, so you obviously get niggles. But I think keeping them contained and not making them into a big injury is their job, and it really helps. And I think it's very
so the last question is, how was your experience about the Mumbai T20 league? Some of your mates have shared their experiences, like Akash Parkar, then Parikshit, then Atif. They have shared their wonderful experiences. So we would like to ask you as well.
I think Mumbai cricket, MPL, is a very, very, competitive league. As Mumbai is one of the best states in India, the players over there are also one of the best in India as well. So even if you take two teams in Mumbai, and even if they play Ranji Trophy, there's a chance of both the teams qualifying for the final. That's how good the Mumbai backbench is. And I think that's what reflects in the Mumbai T20 League, as both the seasons have been quite intense, And it wasn't like, suppose one team is a very strong team and they're going to win it. And it wasn't like that. It was a very competitive and it was a very amazing experience for us, those who haven't played IPL or big leagues, it is a great experience, to experience the pressure or the crowd pressure which we obviously feel in IPL. So I think it is a great exposure to young talents in Mumbai cricket. That they want to play MPL, they want to play Ranji Trophy, and then obviously move ahead. So I think it's an amazing feeling, playing for the franchise you are bought in.
Surely, sir. So surely, sir. I think the questions that we had are over, but there are two segments that are there. One is rapid fire, and other is this or that. So Amog will continue with the rapid fire questions.
Yes, sir. We'll go ahead with the rapid fire round. I'll just ask you, there are 10 questions. So I'll just ask you, it is just a fun segment. You just answer what first comes to your mind. Okay, so the first question is the best prank that you have pulled off among your teammates.
I think best prank. Okay. I don't know.
Is there anything that you can't say on?
It's not like that, but still, you have to think about, you know, the pranks.
Okay, sir. If I may change the question, who's the best prankster in the Mumbai team? Matlab, kaun sabse
jyada prankster sabse jyada prankster? It would be Sarfaraz Khan, for sure.
Sarfaraz Khan.
Yes, definitely. Sarfaraz Khan.
The second question is, do you remember your first Ranji wicket?
My first Ranji wicket, yes, I do remember. I got it after a long time of bowling, around 30-40 hours of bowling. I think, I remember him. I don't remember the batsman's name, but I remember how I got it out. Got him out.
It was bowled. Okay.
Yes. I think, yeah. Yeah, it was bowled.
That's amazing. Then, do you remember your first Man of the Match award?
In Ranji Trophy?
Yeah, Ranji Trophy,
though, I got it when I got a 10-wicket haul. I got my first Man of the Match award.
Okay. One best variation in your bowling that you can rely on anytime?
I think variation and pace is a variation which I rely on. You know, I can rely on anytime.
Okay, who has the worst fashion sense among the Mumbai circuit?
It's a trick question because, you know, everyone thinks that I am the one who wears very different types of clothes and I have a weird fashion sense. So, I'll say it's me.
No, sir. So, we disagree. We have went through your Instagram and we don't think so.
Instagram pictures are different and the ones I wear are different.
Okay, sir, the cheat day meal, agar aapko ek din diya jaye and you know if you are given complete freedom ki aaj matlab jo bhi khaoge wo broccoli ban ke niche utarna hai, so what is the first thing that you will eat?
I think I'll have jalebis because I love them and that's the first thing I'll have, and after that, suppose if everything gets too sweet in my mouth, I think I'll have a pizza to cover it up with a spicy thing. That's it. Yeah.
Okay. A weirdest roommate you've ever had?
So I don't know if this video, if he's gonna see this video, Darshan Bandekar, the guy I was with in Abu Dhabi. I think he has one of the weirdest sleep schedules.
Okay. Which Game of Thrones character do you relate to the most?
Jon Snow.
Okay, and a batting partner that you would like to have from any era?
Any era?
Yeah.
I think it would be Steve Smith, hands down. I don't think anyone else.
Steve Smith.
But sir, in DC camp, you had Steve Smith with you, right?
So yes, I
did you have any opportunity in practice matches, like the intra-squad matches that you have?
I had a practice session with him wherein, you know, I was bowling to him and the wicket wasn't that well prepared, I feel. It was a great opportunity to bowl to someone you've just watched playing on television, you know, who's a hero, who you want to play with. And it was a great feeling for me and I feel very proud of that. I had a practice session wherein I bowled around 40 minutes to him. And it was a great experience for me.
Okay, sir, just one more question that I just thought of spontaneously. If you're bowling and it's a turning track, which fielder would you want in the slip? Any fielder, not just from the Mumbai team, but it can be anyone. Okay. Which fielder would you rely on the most to be in the slip?
I think Surya Kumar Yadav, because he's got some of like blinders in my bowling. So I think I'll choose him.
You know, one more question, sir. Now that you have been part of two squads of IPL, given a choice, the Mega Auction is coming next year. So, given a choice to you, which squad you would like to be part of?
Just anyone that picks me. It's not. I don't have a this thing that I want to go in Delhi or anything, but or Mumbai. I think anyone that picks me is fine by me.
Great to know, sir. We'll go ahead with the this or that round, and Rishi, you can take over.
Yes, sir. So the first question for this or that round is that 2007 World Cup or 2011 World Cup?
11.
Then second question is double your weight or half your height?
You cannot change that. So, matlab aap agar kahoge ki I'll be double my weight or fir baad mein workout karke I can reduce my weight, to waise nahi. You have to stay that lifelong. Matlab double your weight or half your height?
I think double my weight. Well, half my height is not good at all.
Okay.
Okay, sir. So moving on is Mumbai local or BST?
Mumbai local.
Okay. So Sergio Aguayo or Kevin De Bruyne? I'm sorry if I'm spelling them wrong.
Kevin De Bruyne.
Okay. And weekend destination, beach or mountains?
Mountains.
Okay. We were going through your social media. We were going through your Instagram, and we saw you're following Selena Gomez and Kylie Jenner. So, which one you would choose, Selena Gomez or Kylie Jenner?
Selena Gomez.
Okay. Mumbai Indians or Delhi Capitals?
Mumbai Indians.
Making your own bed or living it as it is?
Living it as it is.
Yeah, my mother will say the same. 10 wicket haul or a century?
10 wicket haul.
Okay. Game of Thrones or Friends?
Game of Thrones.
What? Yeah. It ended pretty badly, I think.
Yeah, but the 1, 2, 7 season were good. So I'll.
Yeah, okay.
Yeah.
Okay, I think the questions here I have are done. So is there any
question? One question I want to add up here. So, would you enjoy anchoring the innings for Mumbai or would you enjoy bowling out the opposition?
I think bowling out the opposition, because anchoring the innings, there are a number of people who can do that.
I have watched you live in Chinnaswamy and I've enjoyed your innings, anchoring the innings. You were batting with, I forgot who you were batting with, but you were batting at number 4. And that was a good innings for me.
Yeah. I was batting with Aditya Tare.
Yes.
It was a pretty special.
I have another question. We asked this question to Akash Parker as well. Okay. If you're batting in the Mumbai Nets, would you prefer facing Dhaval Kulkarni or would you prefer facing Tushar Deshpande or Shardul Thakur? Which among the three?
I prefer facing Dhaval Kulkarni.
Yes, he gave the same answer because he said that Tushar is too quick.
Yes, so, Tushar is quick, and in the Nets, it feels like he's 20 kilometers more quicker. So I'll stick with Dhaval.
I don't think Dhaval Kulkarni is giving us interview after this. Who has that chosen to face? So that was a fun session. So thank you very much for giving us your time. It's really a pleasure for us. We are really grateful to have your time, and for the journey that we have started, for students like us supporting us in each step, that we are really grateful to you, and we're happy to have you. And we wish to see you soon in the Indian jersey, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Make sure to follow us on all the platforms on social media. We are the Third Man Cricket Show. We are active on Facebook, LinkedIn, Instagram, and even YouTube. So make sure to hit the bell icon on YouTube as well, where we bring you daily analysis on match days, weekly podcasts, and experts corner shows like today. So we will be really glad if you give us your support. And also, guys, keep yourself safe and your family safe, and follow all the safety protocols and get yourself vaccinated if possible. And till then, I really hope all of you have a great day. Thank you for joining us.